YouTubers!
Hello YouTubers! After all this hauling we've done recently, we thought it's now time to do an empty!
And we have emptied up quite a few things.
Yeah, and we show you skincare and we've got lots of makeup. So stay tuned, that's very interesting. And we start with
our very body butter.
Yeah.
The macadamia nut one. We love that body butter, it's empty.
And we have just taken one to resemble all the cans we've used up. Quite a few of them, actually. That's the only body butter we use. Same as last time, our favorite makeup wipes, the Balea, which is a German brand, and it's in the DM drugstore shop. You can get these. So if you ever come to Germany, Austria, or where you can find a DM drugstore shop and you need makeup wipes,
try them.
They are great.
They are really good.
They are not too wet, not too dry. They are
and
just perfect.
And they have a really perfect price because they cost about €2. Talking about makeup remover, our favorite makeup remover is the Garnier Essential 2-in-1 Makeup Remover.
Yeah, it's the one with the two faces. And this is our holy grail. It's seriously HG material for us. But we tried another one and it's from Sephora. And it's one of these, like the Bioderma triple action cleansing water, and yeah, it was all right, but honestly we still prefer the Garnier one. I think it's about the same price because there's 400 milliliter in there and there's 200 milliliter in there, but we do prefer, especially for waterproof eye makeup, this one gets the eye makeup off a lot better than this one.
Then we used up from MAC the Volcanic Ash Exfoliator.
And oh, we are so sad about that because we loved exfoliator. And I really would like to cut that bottle open, but I'm not sure if you still can back to MAC then if you do that. So I'll just leave it like that. And great, great, great exfoliator. We
it's
love
a great
that.
One. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Then we finished up some eye creams.
My holy grail eye cream is the Clinique Anti-Gravity Eye Cream. I'm using just that eye cream for day and night and I'm loving it.
For many reasons. The eyeshadows don't crease as much when she uses this eye cream. It's hydrating but not really greasy on the eyes. So yeah, this eye cream is really works well for Brigitte's skin.
For my oily eyelids.
And the one I really like is the All About Eyes Rich Eye Cream. I really like that one, especially in the evenings. And for daytime, which was a favorite of mine, is the Estee Lauder for all skin types Resilience Lift Extreme Eye Cream. And I love, love, love that eye cream because it's got a little bit of shimmer in it. So if you don't wear any makeup or something, you still have a little bit of brightness underneath the eyes.
And of course, a little bit of shimmer here.
And it feels really great. I mean, Estee Lauder skincare is just, we love it. We have been loving Estee Lauder skincare for so, so long.
And still do.
And now, let's move on with some more
essentials,
makeup bits. And
yeah, the MAC brush cleaner. Another one is empty. We are just using the MAC brush cleaner.
For spot cleaning.
For spot cleaning with distilled water. Yeah, half-half and it works fine.
Then we've used up for our beauty blender. And you can also wash your brushes with that one. But we still prefer shampoo to wash the brushes. But that's the Beauty Blender Cleanser. It's a nice product, but honestly, I have no problems with washing my beauty blender with antibacterial hand soap. I can't say the hand soap is better or worse than that Beauty Blender Cleanser. It gets the cleanser gets the makeup out really well, but so does the hand soap. So I don't think I will repurchase that one.
And then some face primers.
And I proudly present the MAC Prep and Prime Skin Smoother Base Visage. I have used it up.
Yes, she really struggled with that one because we hate that primer.
Yep. Hate is a strong word, but this product from MAC seriously didn't work for us.
No, not at all.
And I'm still,
it's
you know,
greasy, it's oily, it's, I don't know.
Yeah, we've paid money for it, so I really wanted to use it up still. Oh, I'm just glad it's gone. To say the least about it.
Mm. And the Shiseido Pore Smoothing Corrector.
Which is a nice
face primer. Would we repurchase it? I don't think so.
No, we have got lots of primers to go through.
It's a nice primer, but there are lots of other primers out there which we prefer. And then we have used up foundations.
Yeah, a couple of foundations, and it's the Bourjois Healthy Mix Foundation in 52 Vanilla.
And the Revlon Colorstay Foundation. Would I repurchase the Revlon Colorstay Foundation? Yes, yes, yes.
because in the winter we had lighter skin, so we pulled it out again and we fell back in love with it.
I really love it. I still love it, and I would repurchase
it. And we like the coverage, we like how it goes on.
We like the staying power.
The staying power
is
amazing.
It's very, very good for oily skin, perfect for oily skin, really.
Although in the winter, I must say, when I was a little bit drier, I couldn't use that Revlon Colorstay foundation. Well, at least not the oily combo skin one, because it just didn't work with my somewhat drier skin in the winter. So I have used up the Bourjois Healthy Mix Serum, which Brigitte doesn't like it too much, because for oily skin, this one is definitely a no-go.
It looks really good for about an hour, and after an hour, the foundation just runs down your face. For oily-skinned people like me.
Yeah, and it got patchy on her. It just didn't... Her complexion just really didn't look good with this one. But for the winter, when I had a little bit more of a drier skin, this one worked okay. However, comparing to the staying power of the Revlon Colorstay, this didn't hold up, unfortunately. So, Bourjois foundations, we guess people who like Chanel foundation really would love Bourjois foundations.
Oh, yes.
And we are honestly not the biggest fan of Chanel foundations either. So, it is okay, but definitely not a repurchase for me.
And definitely not for me. And then I have used up the Clinique Airbrush Concealer. I really actually liked it. Would I repurchase it? I don't think so. I liked it, but there are many other concealers out.
Yeah, especially our Garnier Roll-On Concealer works just as well and is, price tag-wise, a lot more...
Better.
User-friendly.
It's just better than the Clinique.
Not better in terms of how it applies and how it works, but it works just the same and it's got a better price tag, so it's better. And
finally, I have used up my Art Deco eyeshadow base. I'm so happy.
It's not an eyeshadow base we would ever repurchase.
No. I made it work for me with the Painterly Paint Pot, but after 5 to 6 hours, my eyeshadow started creasing, but that was fine for me because for just a half day working day, I used that eyeshadow base and... Yeah, it
that way she was able to use it up.
Yeah.
Go with a primer where you know it works, like the Urban Decay, the Too Faced, or our favorite, the NARS. Urban Decay Primer Potion, which I have used up in Eden. Well, it's all dried up now, I can't...
Depotted a long time now.
We depotted it and I can't use that, what's left in there anymore. As you can see, it's not much left, but I can't use it anymore. It's completely dried up. And also some powders we have used up. And one is the L'Oreal Professional, no, Studio Secrets Professional. It was just a translucent powder and that lasted us forever. It's one of the better translucent powders we have tried.
From the drugstore. And yeah, we repurchased it already.
Yeah.
And we also used up the Eclat Mineral Radiance Powder from Bourjois.
Which was an okay powder, but I don't think we would repurchase that one. Mm-hmm. It was nothing special, but it was okay. And we used up 2 gel liners, and one of them we are really proud. It's the MAC gel liner or fluid line in Dark Diversion. And we are really so proud that we used that one up because it also was in one of our products we wanted to use up this year. So, yay! We did it. We managed to use it up. Yeah, I liked it. I mean, but we have 2 purple gel liners by MAC. They are so similar. We didn't need 2, so we used one of them up.
And the Essence Sun Club gel liner in, I don't know, just a brown one.
Yeah, it was a brown one with sparkles in it. Very, very nice gel liners. And we still like the Essence gel liners very much.
And then Cornelia has used up eyeshadows, 2 eyeshadows.
Yeah, one was, you can't see it now because it's empty, but it was a similar color to MAC Brulee and it was in the Alverde Chocolate Quad. And we depotted it and I used it up, I mean... Not too interesting, but I thought I'd show you anyway. And another eyeshadow, which was quite empty anyhow, is the Alverde Baked Eyeshadow in Elegant Beige. And I can't get anything more out of that one.
No.
And I really, really like it.
And we would repurchase that one again.
Yeah.
Definitely. And another MAC product, the Cream Color Base in Pearl.
Yeah.
Empty.
The Cream Color Base Pearl and Cream Color Base Hush by MAC are the only 2 cream highlighters we have. That's why we used it quite a lot.
And actually, Cornelia used it the most.
Yeah, I use the Pearl a lot and Brigitte prefers the Hush. And yeah, it's empty now. Would I repurchase it? No, let's start it that way. Do I like it? Yes, I do like it very much. And Brigitte likes her Cream Color Base a lot also. But honestly, I think we would... Just go and check out another brand and see what other cream highlighters are out there. Just because we love makeup and we love trying new makeup.
And we're curious.
Yeah.
And some lip glosses.
Quite a few, actually.
Yeah.
And one which was one of my favorites and was always in my handbag was the Tarte lip gloss in Archiote or Archiote, Archiote. Kathleen, I know you told us how to pronounce that, but we couldn't remember.
No.
And lip glosses generally are really nice. They're a little bit more on the sticky side, but they have a really nice peppermint scent to it. They last on the lips.
And we got that one in a swap. And also the next one, the NYC lip gloss in Nude York City was the name. You can't see it anymore on here.
And these NYC lip glosses...
Oh, we love them.
Yeah, they are moisturizing. They taste like coconut.
Mm.
They feel good on the lips. NYC lip glosses we really like.
And the Lancôme Juicy Wear Seal and Shine Top Coat.
Yeah, the clear one from the Juicy Tubes by Lancôme. I mean, it is a great lip gloss just to as a topper. Or, you know, if you don't want to wear makeup or something and just want to make your lips a little bit more glowy, then this one was perfect. Felt good on the lips and yeah, it's a nice lip gloss.
And the last lip gloss is the Bourjois Effect 3D Max Lip Gloss in Brilliance 3D
Rose Eclat, number 63. And it gives a very nice shine on the lips. And I understand why people really like Bourjois lip glosses. Because they are moisturizing, they feel good on the lips, and they taste fruity. And even when I'm wearing it, Brigitte once asked me, "What chewing gum are you having in your mouth?" And I said, "I don't have any chewing gum in my mouth. It's that lip gloss." They have a really nice scent, and they are really, really nice. But for the price tag, honestly, I think the NYC are just as good and just as moisturizing. I would always repurchase the NYC over the Bourjois. And last lip product is a lip liner. Again, a product we wanted to use up this year, so yay, we managed to do it. And it's number 11, Peach, but it's a pink lip liner. It was one of these sharpening pencils, and it was an Austrian brand by IQ.
IQ by Bipa, or Look by Bipa. Look by Bipa.
Yeah. Not our favorite lip liners because they're very hard, but yeah, used it up.